The rahmah towards whom? The rahmah towards non-Muslims. The most arrogant thing for a Muslim to do is to think they are the only ones going to Jannah. There are many Muslims out there today arrogantly think they're the only ones Allah created Jannah for. Who are you? Maliki Yawm al-Din? You're not Maliki Yawm al-Din. So why do you walk around like you are Maliki Yawm al-Din? There are many Christians out there who are more Muhammadan in their character than Muslims. There are Jews out there who are more Muhammadan in their character than Muslims. There are others of no faith, but their akhlaq is the best akhlaq. When I see a non-Muslim, Ali ibn Abi Talib showed it beautifully when he said, people are of two types. They are either your brothers in faith or your equals in humanity. That's it. People are either my brothers in faith or my equals in humanity. When the Holy Prophet saw other non-Muslims, did he say kill them because they believe Jesus is the Son of God? Did he say kill them because they believe Moses is? No. قُلْ يَا أَهْلَ الْكِتَابِ تَعَالَوْ. Say, O people of the book, come. إِلَىٰ كَلِمَةٍ سَوَاءٍ بَيْنَنَا وَبَيْنَكُمْ أَلَّا نَعْبُدَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ وَلَا نُشْرِكَ بِهِ شَيْئًا وَلَا يَتَّخِذْ بَعْضُنَا بَعْضًا أَرْبَابًا مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ. O people of the book, I ask all of your question here in this assembly. Torah is the book of the Jews. Do you agree? Injil is the book of the Christians. Do you agree? Quran is the book of the Muslims. Do you agree? Why does Allah say, Ya Ahl al-Kitab, O people of the book, when they are three? Why doesn't Allah say, Ya Ahl al-Kutub, O people of the books? Because He wanted to show us that all of you, your books come from the same source. And that is me, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If all of us reflected on this, that the Quran set a principle that Ya Ahl al-Kitab, not Ya Ahl al-Kutub. O people of the book, Torah, Injil, Quran, no, all of it emanates from one place. Therefore, when you see a Christian, a person walked with Ali, the son-in-law of the Prophet, they went past the church. When they went past the church, the narration mentions that one, his companion said to him, I wonder how much shirk is being done in that church. Ali looked at the cup half full. And he said, I wonder how much Allah is being worshipped in that church. Likewise with us, if we are the people of Rahmah, let's stop condemning non-Muslims to hell and concentrate on getting ourselves into Jannah. And then finally, when you want to see the final piece of Rahmah, Rahmah towards our enemies. It's not easy to be merciful towards one's enemy. Our ego gets in the way. Our arrogance gets in the way. We live in a world of tit for tat. We live in a world where we want to cut people off. But you found the greatest example of mercy ever to be shown was when he became victorious in Mecca. Abu Sufyan, his arch enemy, was alive. You had people like Safwan bin Umayyah. You had people like Sufyan bin Umayyah. You had people like Habbar ibn al-Aswad, Abdullah al-Zab'ari, Wahshi, the one who cut open his uncle on the day of Uhud. Yet the Holy Prophet looked at all of them. People were expecting the Holy Prophet to kill them because they thought that because they're his enemies, he's going to finish them. But he said, no, today is Yawm al-Marhama. Today is the day of mercy. Today is a day where I show all of you that true power is not using it. It's to hold back from using it when you can use it. I can use power, but I won't. Because more beautiful in the eyes of Allah is when I use rahmah instead of using force. Inshallah, if all of us begin to implement rahmah and the rahmah lil alameen into our lives, then we'll see a healthier Pakistan. And in my humble opinion, every generation, there is a source of rahmah. The Holy Prophet was the first, his Ahlul Bayt one after the other, and even every generation since then. And you are fortunate to have a Prime Minister like Imran Khan, and you're fortunate to have a Minister of Religious Affairs like Dr. Al-Qadri. Don't abuse this rahmah, make use of it. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Thank you.